I'm Dan Myers from Quincy Art Association. I teach portrait and figure sculpture at the Quincy Art Association. And my partner, Chris Kreitman, we run the Tuesday night open studio life drawing class. And that's been my function at Quincy Art for about 20 years. The library, again, has graciously and generously given me a month to show my work at the library up near the circulation desk. And this would be the third time they've done it. I did it in 2007, 2012, roughly every 5 years. And I'm going to have sculpture, fabulous fake art, some drawings and paintings of my family, and some life drawing examples to display for the public for the month of June. I call it just Dan Myers Art at the Library, retrospective number 3, human-centered art, because it's universally about people. The last exhibit was in 2012, so all this work has been created subsequent to that. And my centerpiece, the one I'm very proud of, is the Faith, Hope, and Love. It's a sculpture. It takes up quite a bit of space. And it got honored by the Art Renewal organization. It was in their 12th Salon. It's an international show of realistic art about 2016. So that's, I consider that the centerpiece. And it's fairly large. It features at least 8 figures. It's got a family group on top with a mother, father, son, and daughter, and 4 cherubs that represent all the ethnic groups of humanity. That sculpture is cast in polyurethane resin, and it's got just a white finish to make it look sort of like marble. It doesn't fool anybody, but it was created in plastilina, which is synthetic clay. It took, I'd say, 3.5 years because there were 3 prototypes. It took me every prototype, I had a different idea, and it took me till the last prototype to figure out I wanted them floating in the air, not just standing. So with the idea changes, and it's about 1,000 hours of work altogether, but it took 3.5 years to, incubate. The Fabulous Fake category, it's in its 4th year. My friend Dan McCall of South Boston came up with the idea of inviting artists to copy great artwork that they loved or interpret it in some creative way. So we've had this category at both the Marina Bay Show and Quincy Arts Fest for, this would be its 4th year. So, and artists love it. The public seems to love it. There's so many fun ways you can approach it. And this year we've added photography as a medium for the first time. So we're seeing what photographers can do with a great piece of artwork or a great photograph and how they reinterpret that. So that'll be new this year, and it's the 4th year. That one is called Nude Gallery 1 because I got Nude Gallery 2 this year. And that's a painting of one of our models at the Quincy Life class. Up in the corner you've got Matisse. Down below is Picasso, I believe. Over on the right is Bouguereau, and on the bottom right is Modigliani. So it's 3 modern art treatments of the nude, and Bouguereau is considered the greatest figure painter of the 19th century. So it's a lot of representations of the human body and how artists have looked at it over the years. That image is, I call that life class drawing. Of course, we had particular model didn't appear at our life class. That came out of a photograph. And I call that spectrum. I have several names, so either spectrum or free fall. So again, the nude is central to the life class effort, and one of my favorite subjects. My favorite part is these two. My grandson Jack and granddaughter Eva Rose. He's about 5.5. She's about 14, 15 months, almost ready to walk. And I have several images of them I'll have at the library, including other members of my family. The reception will be Saturday, June 9th from 1 to 3. And the public is invited to come. And I will answer questions then for sure if anybody has a particular question about medium or how to get involved with Quincy Art. And everybody's welcome to come. My overall message to my other friend artists is come to the library, get involved, and apply to Clayton Cheever and Megan Allen to show your artwork. I think this library is a jewel itself. It's the cultural jewel of this city. It's a beautiful place to display your art, and all artists. I have a lot of good friends who are great artists who have never shown their work here. And I would implore them to, share it with the public. And this is a wonderful place for it. We have a lot of aspiring artists at least coming to our life class. Some very young folks, one of which took the Quincy TV video course with us. And he's gotten very involved, and we're very thrilled that he's getting involved with us. And he wants to go in the direction of a graphic novel. Even did a little time-lapse photography based on what Bill Early taught him in the TV video thing. So, young artists, we'd love you to come to our life class if you're 18 or older. And very young artists, come to our art classes on Saturday taught by Yale Colbeck and show your work at the Quincy Art Fest. You could come to our website, is the easiest, quincyartma.org, or come to, there's two things coming up that might be of interest. One specific to Quincy Art is July 20th. It's a Friday from 5 to 8, and it's part of Margaret LaForest's Discover Quincy Friday nights. So we will have an open house. A lot of things will be going on. We'll hang some of our artwork in the building. We'll have refreshments. I think there's something going on outside, activities for kids. And there will be four artists, myself included, doing a portrait of Uncle Sam Rounceville, who is our local celebrity and local P.T. Barnum. And we will be doing his, three of my friends will do his portrait in oil, and I will do it in clay. And we'll have the cameras rolling. And he never disappoints in discussing life in general, so he will be extremely entertaining and fun for all to watch the artists try to portray him. So that's July 20th. The other thing, also involving Uncle Sam Rounceville, June the 14th at the Quincy Historical Society, Sam is having a media event. My last portrait clay class sculpted him. He was our model. And so we have four portraits of him in clay. I went ahead and did his wife Jean in clay, and Quincy Historical Society is also accepting my portrait of Abigail Adams. So at least seven sculptures, I think, will be there, and Uncle Sam will be there, and it should be quite fun.